Hey guys, Paisteboy here. Trails are closed temporarily because we had a little warm spell yesterday, but hopefully they'll be open in the next couple days. Got to hook up the electric cable for my heated shield because that was kind of tough riding without that hooked up, so I'm going to take a stab at that. Check it out. Oh yeah, and I got my brother's sled here. It's a 2002 MXZ 700. It's got the RER reverse. It's got, I think, 6-inch risers on his. Take a step back. Just had a bunch of work done on the motor there. Had some bad luck last year. But, freaking nice sled. Check the mileage here. $3,500. Yep, got less mileage than me. But, pretty cool sled. Alright, so back to my sled. It's cleaner. Alright, so what I gotta do. Found this connection here, and I'm going to test it out, this little tester here. So let the starter up and see if we got power for starters. Alright, let's start her up. Definitely got power here, and this is the cable that I have to hook up. The other end looks like this, just two connectors on it. So basically, if I just plug them into this, should have power. That's pretty simple. So let's give that a shot and see if we could. I mean, it's kind of going to be hard to tell if it's getting electricity to the shield, but let's give it a shot. This is my helmet. It's an HJC LS AirTech 2. It's got to be AirTech 20 by now because I bought this thing like 14, 15 years ago. But, took a little break from snowmobiling while the kids were growing up. So, still had the helmet. Let's give this a shot. It's got the connection right here. So, start with connecting these two here. Not sure if it matters which one goes where, but I got red to red, black to black. Just to be safe. That's connected. And then this is the cable that goes to the helmet. And it's got the little curly Q thing so you can. Just make a connection here. Good. And got it connected to the helmet. We'll start it back up. Well, it's kind of hard to tell if it's working exactly or not, but what I'm going to do is permanently put this cord in place, and that way when I do go riding this weekend, I'll make a video for you guys too, and hopefully it'll be working, but let's get it in place. All right, since the connection on the helmet's on the left side, I'm going to feed the wire through on the left side, and I just found this little opening here. I think I'm going to do it there. I was going to do it through one of these little holes, but it's probably better here. So, I'm just going to push those through here. Perfect. All right, so got it right through there, right here, and I'm just gonna fasten it, you know, down at the other end, plug it in, should be good. So let's go on the other side. All right, so here's the cable, it's a little long. Here's the connector. And so just as long as I keep it under here, we should be good. So let me do that. All right. Got some black zip ties, some electrical tape, and my cutters. So, let's see how we're going to route this. If I keep it tight down along here, then I don't have to worry about the cord pulling back out over there. So, let's see. Put a zip tie right around here. All right. That ought to keep it there. Cut that off. And then, I gotta find a. First, I'm gonna connect this. I'm gonna put a little electrical tape around these ends. Good. All right, so red on red and black with black should be good. And kind of just gonna put one more zip tie on here just to keep it bundled up, and it should be fine. Not exactly sure what this accessory connection was for, so I'm kind of hoping, you know, nothing. There's another one here, too. I guess I could look at the manual later before I actually use it, just to make sure it's not a problem. But a friend of mine told me, you know, there's a lot of accessory connectors that you could hook up to. I don't see the harm in it. Go. I don't know if I should Put one more to keep it from moving. Alright, what I went and did was I tucked the wire behind these two wire harness connectors and then just tucked it down in here. And that's going to work just fine. So hopefully that gives me what I need. I did a continuity test at the end of the cable, including, you know, the extra cable that connects to the helmet, and it was getting electricity. So as long as the visor still works, I think this is going to do the trick. And we'll see you on the trails.